Hello and welcome back to Swanage-mode Railway. This is part three of the path project, and I'm going to say the paths that I've got at the moment are now in their final stage and complete. Still need to add a few people around, but I've now got the benches and everything fitted down to the pavements. Got all my street lights working. I didn't actually show the wiring up of those or installation of pretty much all of them, but they're all in, wired in and working. Got traffic lights in. You'll have seen the build video I got before this one, but that was installed during this later half of this project, and you see installed in this video as well. So I'll take you around several of the areas. Also, several of the vehicles are now fixed down to the layout. The larger vehicles are not fixed down as the size and weight of them. But we now have more vehicles fitted to the layout, which will speed up setup time at shows, as we no longer have to get them in and out of the boxes. So in this part of the video, I'm also going to say that during the putting of the plaster down, several of the curb stones came loose due to the water content of the filler. But after thinking about it for a little while, realising that it actually makes it look more realistic to not have the perfect curb stones going around the corner. So in that mind, I quite like them as they are now, so I glued them in place. So I'll just take you around a few bits of the layout. So, got a few bits to still repaint, like on that pole, got to get some green paint on it again. So, little vehicles are glued down, we've got new tables and benches on the platform and on the streets. Bus shelter, which is fixed in place. Still got another one to come for over there, as well as a few more benches, but I ran short. And then still gonna have to continue that along. But yeah, all the street lighting looks pretty amazing. Also got the observation car fixed up. So I now have that screw back in place. Thanks for the tip to use a little bit of threadlock, but I used a bit of nail varnish instead, as it is more better for plastics. Some threadlocks don't work well with plastics, neat plastic, so used a little dab of nail varnish to lock them in place. Then proceeding on to this panel, we have this truck now locked in place here. This section is going to be the next bit to be worked on. So, all of these vehicles on the bridge are also fixed in place. Okay, so now I have just mixed up this plaster. Nice thick consistency, not too runny, as I'm about to start doing some of these paths. I can't do this one because I'm unsure how it leads off, but we'll get this one, the one under the camera, and some of the stuff on the panel, first panel, done. Hopefully I've got enough mixed up. So let's have a go at this. Okay, so now that I have moved the panel, let's add the light. We are ready to start on the next phase. Still can't add the path thing in just yet to here. And I'm not doing the opposite side of the road until both sides are ready. Otherwise, why bother mixing up the filler to do that side? Alright, so now we've got some fence lines, which I just put roughly into where they have to go. So that we can now fence these areas. I've also got a big gate to go over there. And I shall adapt another fence, or adapt that gate to make a smaller one. So now that we've got all of that, I can get that fence line fully installed. Once I've got that installed, I'll be able to put the paths in. Also have this little junction box, which will be located behind or in front of that fence next to the traffic lights, which are now working. Just won't be able to power them up right this moment. So yeah, moving on, let's start working on this fence line. Okay, so it appears the last segment didn't actually record, and that was painting these areas. So this area is now painted all the way down, as is all the other sections of path that I have done. I'll quickly take the camera around them. We've got those bits there, all the way down. Got the section up here and that path there. Now if I swing you around there, we also got the little bit of path on the corner of that one. As that is all painted and set, the next task is to start populating the scene. And to do that, first off, I have a bus shelter, which is one of the Hornby scaled ale ones, just painted black. So that's to go over there. Also got some bins from West Hill Wagon Works. So at the moment I'm going to want one of those. And I have some benches from Metcalf. Just some basic benches that I can install that people will be sitting on. So let's get to installing those. I'll be using my all-purpose glue. Okay, so I'm now at the point where I get to put a few of these vehicles onto the layout. Now that the paths are all done, I can start putting them on without risk of getting them covered in plaster or paint. So, got a few out here. I've even got my little fire engine with the beautiful mural on the side that I love. This one will be staying loose, as well as the bus over here, due to their size. Can't trust that something with this much size and weight will stay fitted down with just the walls being glued down. But smaller vehicles like these ones, I have more trust in that they'll stay put. I've just got to pick where I'm going to put them. So I reckon that one at the giveaway lines there. Van coming past the giveaway line to there. Fire truck will just be loose anyway, so we'll just move them over there. An orange Jeep will be waiting at the traffic lights. that's going to be about it for this video. Thank you all for watching. Feel free to subscribe if you haven't already to get notifications when my latest videos come out. Hope you enjoyed it, as I have much enjoyed doing this three-part project. Look forward to doing more projects into the future. Don't know how long it's going to take for me to get the next video out after this. I still haven't figured out how much is involved in that project yet. But it should be a good one. Alright, see you in the next one. Thanks for watching.